you've designed to be like the one you gave the pattern on the mount. Like playing in the hands of the potter, I ask, make me a sweet fire, you break me
Fellowship. I want to come down to NCCF Taraba Our sensei rabbi is Nigerian Christian Fellowship in Taraba State, which those coming to the fellowship are coppers, and they are referred to as Jesus coppers. Reason being that the NCCF itself was a prophecy, and everybody belonging to that canopy is identified with the author of the prophecy, which is Jesus Christ. That's where the name comes from, Jesus coppers. So NCCF Taraba State has been having some peculiarity, not really compared to other chapters of NCCF in other states. Particularly, God has been so evident in all our programs. There have been healings and deliverance. The mighty hands of God have been felt in all our programs. And God has really seen us through, despite the fact that He's among the Northeast. And many people have been afraid to come to this area. But the little that have been here, God has been so faithful. And I believe if we get to ask them, they will even wish to come here again to serve because of the peculiarity and because of the great things God has been doing in NCCF Taraba chapter. To begin with, I would love to say that I thank God for the vision, because before now I've been having it in my mind if my drama director would have such a vision. So I was so happy it as though it was a coincidence that he came with such a vision. Why was I having such thought? I've been privileged to be with him in some invitations to some churches, some churches like this guy. Another invitation, I've seen the way they act. And I want to say that it can be compared to some of this, his drama and the act can be compared to even some international dramas that they acted. And beyond that, all of the drama I've watched him acted and passed tremendous message, which is in line with the core vision of NCCF. So while he told me, I was so happy. Even looking at the team for the drama, the Quiver, I was so great, I was so happy, and I felt so elated in my spirit, knowing too well that something great will happen, knowing too well that the same person that I've been acting, that I've been privileged to watch, the same person is involved. And if I get this message from the little actor, how much more if you want to prepare a drama that really go all the whole world? I believe this is going to go to the most part of the world. So I expect something great that really preach to many. I will convert that, because the drama I've seen him acted has really inspired me and have really touched me and have kept me to ruminate on many things in my life. And I've really come to a great conclusion that of a truth, this drama will bring nothing but the best. If I will say that the slogan in the chapel, say my chapel here, let them keep the fire burning. The fire must not really get off from the altar. And like the slogan also said that Jesus copper never die. It's my prayer that all the Jesus copper belonging to the body NCCF in Taraba chapter, for them not to really die spiritually and physically. And it's also my earnest prayer that all the people belonging to NCCF Taraba chapter to uphold the vision that NCCF stands for. And the vision is really to go out there and make disciples for Christ. Haven't made disciples of themselves. So it is my prayer that God should give them the grace and everything they need to carry out the vision even to the uttermost part of the world. And also my prayer that as many of them will be leaving, especially the Basi, very soon, another by coming forth, my prayer that the fire will not just be when they are necessary. Let me go to the end of their journey.
If I have anything to say, I'll just say this. Lord Jesus Christ is strong in the Lord and in the might of His word. As the angel of the Lord told Gideon to be of a good strength and to go in the might of what he had heard, I want to say, in the might of the prophecy that gave birth to NCCF, I would say, go in that might. As a product of prophecy, you can do nothing but to fulfill God's prophecy. And there are more prophecy to be fulfilled, there are more grounds to cover, there are more battles to conquer. Above all, keep the fire burning. Do not allow the fire of God to leave your altar. If there's anything you need to do, is to be strong in the Lord. First of all, ground yourself first before you go out there to do the rah-rah again. Be involved in God. Have personal relationship before you go out there to introduce God to other people. Make sure that you are rooted before you go out there to root other people. Anything you want to do out there, whether in rural rugged, in hospital visitation, in prison visitation, let me start from you first. Because the message that comes from life speaks more than even words. Like somebody will say, preach always, but speak when necessary. And if your ability of talking is taken away from you, will your life speak for you? You're a Christian. So above all, live a Christian life and prepare for heaven as you do this work, so that you will not do God's service outside the will of God. This is my little piece of advice and my message for all the Jesus Copper all over the Federation.
My name is Ocho Tai Emmanuel. I'm General Secretary of the Rabba State Chapter. So as a Jesus Copper, as individual, that we have to remain in the quiver. When you remain in the quiver, God will be able to use you. David remained in the quiver. That's why God was able to use him to rescue and to deliver his people from the uncircumcised Philistine. Naomi left the plan of God for her life. That's why you see, even at the end of her life, she regretted leaving the plan. And for us not to regret leaving the plan of God for our life, for us not to regret, and for God to use us mightily, we have to live, we have to stay in the quiver of God, so that God can take us as Harrow in his mighty hand and send us to destroy every hand, every work of iniquity, and also to preach, that is, to preach the gospel, which is the primary assignment of all Christians. All
right, the only advice I will give them, based on the title of this film, is to remain in the quiver, to remain and to be where God wanted to be, so that God can mightily use them. Like how God used Moses, how he used David, because they decided to stay and to remain in the quiver. They remain in the quiver, so that's why God removed them and used them and sent them as a harrow in the hand of a mighty man. When the Bible says in the book of Psalm 127, it says, like harrow in the hand of a mighty man, so are the children of the Lord. Happy is the man that has his quiver full of them. He shall not be ashamed, but he shall stand in the gate of his enemy. For us to stand in the gate of our enemy, for God to mightily use us as his arrow in the hand of a mighty man, we have to remain in his quiver. So I tell all Jesus Copper here in Taraba State and all Nigeria that is nationwide, I ask and I tell them, I implore them to stay and remain in the quiver. God bless you.
My name is Corey Kokubisayo Titus. I'm the SCCF drama director production. And though I am not the writer of the film, the person that handed over to me that wrote the film, the person of Mr. Apollon, who was very on it. Though when he told me about the project, you know, I was initially afraid, because I know what it takes to shoot a movie. But thank God for the vision. Because, you know, it is one thing to have a vision, and it is another thing to run with the vision. So I want to thank God for giving him the spirit and the zeal to work with the vision. The experience has been great. The experience has been wonderful. God really helped us. But, you know, in any project, we must face one or two challenges. We face a lot of challenges, like the first one was finance. There was no enough finance in the first place. And the second one was the, you know, coordination of the Jesus Copper. I mean, it's not easy to coordinate your fellow copper. So all of us are graduates. Thank God. And the greatest challenge we had was the day we went to Mount Village at Castle Local Government. That day I was afraid. I was very, very afraid, because they were entering the village. We saw the villagers, you know, following us with dagger and different kinds of, you know, the weapons. Thinking that they knew they are coming to hunt us. So they followed us down to the village and we started shooting the people. We even there, they were looking at us. Every man bought a gun. Here's a vision. And also, I want to tell them that they should show myself to try and walk the vision in their life. The title of this project is The Quiver. I want to advise them to always stay in the quiver, to always seek direction, to always seek the instruction from their creator.
Don't you know you need so much?
When what are you paying for?
Don't you know I need so much?
Any life?
Don't you know I need so much?
the enemy wants to fight back. And one of the weapons he uses to introduce this feeling of peace.
And that you've always been for me. And you've always been for me. That's a cut to you, my brother.
That's a
cut
to you, my brother.
That's a kid to you, my sister.
That's a kid to you, my sister.
So high on your mind.
I know where I came from, but
success to success, we will go.
Oh,